Everspace 2. Is it worth a buy? Let's read the words of the developer. Everspace 2 is a fast-paced single-player spaceship shooter with deep space exploration in space and on planets. Tons of loot, RPG elements, mining and grinding and mining and grinding and mining and grinding and mining and mining and crafting. Experience a thoughtful story set in a vivid handcrafted open world full of secrets, puzzles and perils.
We'll start with the graphical options. There's quite a few, guys, and there's also a few HUD options that you can tweak. And there's also some input options. You can play this with a hot ass straight out the gate. You can play it with a controller, or you can play it with a mouse and keyboard. You can rebind all your keys, but it still hard binds F. Even though you can rebind it, but it will still be used as F in the game, and there's nothing you can do about that. That needs fixing. But hey, brilliant control systems. Straight out in early access, you can use all of these different things, which puts a lot of AAA games to shame, because even AAA games, a lot of them release with no hot ass support at all. So that's a big plus. And I'll tell you something, mouse and keyboard is the way to go. It is fantastic. See, it's not like a simulator where you need like 30 different keys just to pilot it. There's no power management and things like that. Basically, you have a left strafe, a right strafe, thrust forward, thrust back, roll left, roll right, and then a couple weapon keys. Well, to be honest, your mouse wheel does that because most ships only have a couple of weapon hard points. So mouse wheel forward and back, switching weapons. And then you'll have a devices, which will be your 1, 2, 3, or whatever it is on your devices. And that's pretty much it, apart from a boost key, which is your sprint key, if you like. So yeah, there's a couple of other things, but nothing really massive. So very, very usable with a mouse and keyboard. And if you're worried about it being a flight simmy kind of game, nah, it's piss easy to control. And not a lot of controls. It fills the hole that's in the market for an arcadey kind of space game. This fits that description perfectly. Now, it has a story, but it's in early access at the minute, so the story's nowhere near complete. There's about 10 hours of it in the early access with incomplete cutscenes and voiceovers. And it wasn't that good. It wasn't very enthralling, to be honest with you. I couldn't really get into it. I'd have much rather that just didn't have a one and just did what Elite did and just says, right, there you go. You are Commander Arseface. There's the universe. Do what the what the. But you follow a story, and if you don't, you're going to miss out on tons of XP, weapons, modules, and things like that. Let's talk a little bit about your ship. Your ship, there's about five different ships. I didn't count them all, but it felt like there was about five. I got rid of my starting ship pretty soon on and got myself a gunship, which was like a more tanky, had less shields, but way more armor and more weapon hard points. It does insane damage and can take a beating as well. So it's perfect for people like me who are a total shite shot. So that worked out great. What you have on your ship, you've got your weapon modules. Now your weapons do two types of damage. One takes down shields and the other really takes down armor. Now all weapons will do both types of damage, but some do way more against shields and some do way more against armor. So you need to have both types equipped so that when a ship with shields is coming at you, you can switch to your shield anti-shield weapon. When you've burned through the shields, kill them with your armor damaging weapon. There's also secondary weapons, which are basically heat-seeking missiles, mines, or huge missile batteries that you fire at big capital ships. Well, not capital ships, but rather big ships. There's also modules. Now you have a shield module, you have armor module, there's power module, and basically the higher the numbers, the better they are. They all have the RPG colors, as do the weapons, uncommon, common, rare, epic, and things like that. So you've got to look for the different types of buff that you get by having a rarer type of module or weapon, because these buffs can be game changers, really. You can also craft all of these things, which is great. The crafting system is excellent. You can craft all different rarities of weapons, and you level up with your when you're crafting and when you're dismantling things, you actually level up, so you can then unlock the next blueprints and things. So it's a big kind of game in its own, the crafting game, just to try and get to the best good stuff. You unlock new blueprints all the time, and you disassemble everything to get the crafting materials to craft new and better things. So it's a nice big loop of gameplay. I love the crafting, to be honest. It's really good. In fact, nearly everything on my ship is handcrafted by me. I've spent tons of time doing the actual crafting. Really, really good. The atmosphere in the game is excellent. You have different systems that you can jump using a jump gate to. Each system will have a lot of different planets. Different planets will have different bases that you can dock at, different space stations or different freighters that you can dock onto. These will have shops, they'll have message boards, wait, mission boards rather, and they'll also be part of the story where you'll get main quests and side quests. And as you go on a quest, you will jump to a specific system where there's a quest, and that puts you in like an instanced little map. Now it does have borders, it does have edges, so you can fly into the edge. It doesn't happen very often. The maps are reasonably big in size, but when you're doing a quest, just be aware you will be in a little... You can't just fly anywhere. You can't just fly off into space like you can in Elite. You're kind of stuck in these little instance areas, and the only way out of them is to jump out of them back to the main solar system, if you like, and then you can jump from planet to planet from there, or a jump gate to a completely new system. There's about 10 hours in early access in the first system. It's like a tutorial, really. And then you get out of that. The story ends there for early access, but it will continue on, obviously, when the game's finished. But you can still access the other systems, do all the side quests, and there's about another 25 hours of gaming to be done, just grinding around and doing side quests and upgrading your ship and buying new ships. So there's plenty to do in early access. There should be, because it's £31, which is quite a lot, I think, for an early access game. Although that is discounted from the final price of the game. In other words, when the game's finished, it's going to be more than £31. So if you jump in now, then you'll save yourself some money when the game actually releases, because obviously you get the full game when it releases. Now, it's not all good, guys. There's some bad stuff in this game. The thing that I don't like, apart from the story and all of that, is some of the mission types are just awful, in my opinion. I mean, I know there's a lot of people love them, but there's a lot of puzzle missions in this. You'll go underground, which is fine. I don't mind going underground in big mines. That's cool. In fact, I love it, actually. It's really good fun. But you'll have to try and find secret stashes, and to do that, you might have to pick up a sphere. Now, when I say pick up, the front of your ship picks things up, and you hold it in place like you've got hands. And it might be an energy sphere that you deposit in an energy socket, which powers a door, which opens, and in the behind the door, there's a weapons crate, or a crate with materials in. And there's shit tons of this stuff happening. Some of it's timed, and there's even one where there's a race, and you can activate a race through these. It's like you're playing a really immersive space game, then all of a sudden it says, hey, look, there's a race here. Why is that there? This is an immersive space game. Yeah, no, but we just thought it'd be funny to put a race here, and you race through all of these things. And I know it makes you realize that you're not really the pilot in this space game, and you've lost all your immersion, but we just put it in. Why? Are you going to go for the full-on, like, the crew and just have lots of shite on your UI? Oh, there's a race here. Oh, do 16 loop-the-loops around here. Follow the loops and you'll get some off. Oh, fuck off, please. Oh, please do not go down that route. Get rid of them, please. Absolute trash. It's supposed to be an immersive RPG space game, and then you go and put a stupid thing like that. A race through a fucking derelict freighter. God. And then it gets worse, guys. You've got boss fights. I had a boss fight with this guy, and I was really looking forward to it, because he had all this stuff on his shield, and it was like he had three bars on his ship, and I'm like, oh, what the hell is this? Until I realized that the first bar is impenetrable shields, guys. Even though my guns can fire through shields and armor, they didn't work against him, because the only way to get his first line of defense down, guys, is to pick up a broken drone that you shoot. Yeah, and throw it at him. You actually ride up to him and then sling it at the front of his ship, and that takes down his shield so you can shoot him. I'm not even going to comment anymore, because, no, just f*** off. There you go. Me bell doesn't like that. And this is the problem with the game. You can be playing it, and it's so immersive and so cool, and you're doing these space fights, and there's about five or six enemy ships coming at you, so you fire your big AoE device, which cripples them all for 8 seconds, and then you're spinning around with your thrusters, strafing left with your thrust on to do it like a handbrake turn, and you're hammering them with your auto cannons and blowing them up, firing missiles at them, and it's fantastic and really good fun. And then 2 minutes later, you'll be picking shit up, working out a puzzle and dropping this into there. Or that the battery, pick the battery up, put the battery in the generator, pick up the sphere of energy. Oh, but it only lasts 20 seconds and I've got to get all the way around there to dump it. Oh, there's an asteroid. We've got to blow that up. And you have to press use on the detonated charges around the asteroid. But you only have 5 seconds to click them. So you're flying round and round like a fucking prick trying to click them. I mean, what is this bullshit? It's like a mobile fucking mini game. And then you go back into a proper space game where it's fun again, where you're having great space fights and stuff. And then you go back and do some of the stupid, fucked up, boring puzzle, unimmersive, pile of shite mission. And one of the biggest problems I had, as somebody who's played Elite and Privateer and going back years and years playing multiple types of space game, was a scanner. A scanner where you can see, a 3D scanner, so you can see whether the ship's in front, behind, above you, or below you. There is none in this game. Now, I have heard they're going to work on one, but how can you release a game without a scanner? It's just, it makes combat really, really confusing, I would say, because you're trying to work out who's the closest, where they are, is there anybody coming towards you? You've just got no information on them whatsoever. I'm still going to thumb it up because I've had some great time. I played it for 18 hours and I've had some great fun crafting, fighting. And when you get that synergy going with your weapons and you get the real power coming out of your weapons, it's just awesome, just melting the enemies and then firing your devices off and doing your crafting. I've had some fun. It's just a shame that it's tainted by bullshit. That's all. It's just bullshit that doesn't belong in a space game. So there you go, guys. I can't wait for this to be released. I'll give it a full review when it comes out. But at the minute, in early access, yeah, worth jumping into if you can stomach the bullshit.